Okay, today's ingredients that we will need for our gumbo is kosher salt, chicken, that's some chicken thighs. We got gumbo filet, some Old Bay seasoning, some cayenne pepper, zatarans, some parsley flakes, andouille sausage, and the Trinity. We got bell pepper, celery, and onion. This onion came out of my garden. I grew that this year, and it's as fresh as you can get. As a matter of fact, just cut it up. And we're gonna need a roux. So I got a cup of flour and a cup of oil, along with my black iron pot for my roux. So that is the ingredients we will need today for our gumbo. Okay, in preparation for my gumbo today, I got some chicken necks and some gizzards, and I'm making some stock,
and then
some
chicken stock.
I got my okra over here that I bought from the store, some fresh okra, and I'm going to be frying that down so I can put that in my gumbo. All right, remember the chicken stock I was telling you about?
Got a gallon of water in there,
and you're looking at about 8 teaspoons of kosher salt. So you're looking at 2 teaspoons per quart, or per liter. My okra's boiling real good. You see all that slime? Okay, when I get done with that, all that slime's gonna be gone. And I'm gonna smother that down. It's gonna get thick, but it won't be slimy. That's the reason I fry it down before I put it in my gumbo. I don't like whole okra in my gumbo. And now we're boiling. Boiling on our chicken stock. Let that boil. I got my gizzards in there too, where they get a good start on getting tender. Okay, let me show you where I'm at with my okra. I've taken my potato smasher here, and I'm helping it out fall apart. We still got a ways to go.
Okay, my chicken stock is done. And I'm going to strain out the chicken necks
and get them out of there for right now. And if you want to nibble on that, you can. I just bought them. They're cheap, and they make good chicken stock. So that's why I got them. Okay, all I got left now is my gizzards. Oop, I'm fogging up there. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, at this point, my okra, as you can see, it's nice and soft. Alright? So I'm going to take that, and I'm going straight to the strainer with it. Get that pot right there. Let me show you what we got here. You see all that? That's what I want to get out of there. It's all that slime. That's what you want right there. See how nice and thick? And that's gonna go good in that gumbo. And most of your slime is gone. So we're going to let that drain a little bit, and that's going to cool off, but that will be going into the gumbo. Okay, out of the okra that I smothered, I took 2 cups of that, about 2 cups of smothered okra, and that's what I'm going to be adding to the gumbo. Alright guys, remember those 3 bags of the Trinity I showed you? Well, what I have done is I have mixed my own pre-mixed there. So I got all my Trinity in there. I got onions, bell pepper, celery, and some parsley. Well, it's the same thing you get out of the store. So, but if you grow your own bell pepper and your own onions and stuff, you know, all you gonna have to do is get your celery and then you put it together, and it's much cheaper that way. All right, guys, look, I'm making my roux for my gumbo. And again, like I was showing you the ingredients in there, I have 1 cup of flour and 1 cup of oil. Alright guys, so just to let you know
where I'm at and what I'm doing. Today we're making a gumbo, and we'll put it together for my South African buddies. I told them I was going to make another video. So, hello, George. Hello, Trevor. And this gumbo's for you. And I'd like to introduce my buddy.
I'm Don. How you doing?
Mr. Don Guidry.
Say, South Africa.
And he will be assisting me today in drinking beer and making gumbo.
Watching LSU baseball.
And watching the LSU baseball game. All right, guys, look, I'm to the level now where my roux is just about done. I'm fixing to put my onions in there. And when I put them onions in there, it's going to turn dark. It's going to get real dark. And I'm almost to that point now. All right, guys, I'm to the point now. I'm going to go ahead and turn my fire off. And I'm going to take my onions. I'm going straight into the roux with it.
Now, the roux is going to get a little darker as the onions and stuff cooks down. Put the shit in the pot, Pete.
Yeah. And also, guys, this will stop the roux from cooking. Okay, guys, remember that chicken stock I made earlier? Well, I've been kind of letting it cool. But now I got my roux cooked. The roux cooking is still hot, and I got my chicken stock on here. Now I also put my gizzards in there, so they getting tender, right? So at this point I'm gonna take this roux a little bit at a time, and I'm gonna put it in this water. I'm gonna bring that to a boil, and I'm gonna let that cook a little bit. So when I get all my roux in here and mixed up and get it boiling real good, I'll come back. All right, guys, I'm back. My roux is in there. I'm slowly bringing it up to a boil. But I'm going to go ahead and put the rest of my onions in here and let that cook a little bit. I'm going to bring that to a boil and let it cook. Okay, guys, I got my fire started right here on my big pan, my big black iron pan. I'm going to go ahead and chicken that up. Cut up. Remember the chicken I showed you earlier on the bone? Well, me and my wife deboned it and cut it up. Okay, guys, remember that okra we cut up earlier? Well, I went ahead and I smothered that down. I told you I got about 2 cups of okra here that smothered down. Okay, now you don't have to put this okra in your gumbo, all right? I personally like the okra taste of that goes in a gumbo.
Down in South Louisiana, okra gumbo is a big thing.
Yeah, and in South Louisiana, like Don said, it's a big deal to put okra in your gumbo. So I'm going to go ahead and
But Don don't like it.
Don hates it. Don hates okra. So now I got my okra in there, and we're going to let that come back to a boil. Okay, and in goes my chicken. That's why I like my big pan. It fits a lot of chicken. Now I'm going to go ahead and cook that down and brown that up. And then I'll fry down my sausage. Okay, guys, I got it where I want it. So I'm going to take this chicken out. And it goes straight into my pot. Okay, I'm bringing all that fat off of that chicken. And all the juices. Now I'm going to take my sausage and put my sausage in the same pan and fry my sausage down. When my sausage is done, I'll be back. Okay, my sausage is done. I'm going to go ahead and transfer it over to my gumbo. It is rendered. When I get it all into the pot, I'll come back and show you what I do with the rest of it. Okay, guys, you see this leftover grease right here? I'm going to go ahead and dump some of this grease. And then I'm going to put it back on the fire. You see all that brown na-na on the bottom there?
We call that na-na down here.
I got some leftover onions here. I'm going to dump that in there. Those onions are going to take all that stuff off the bottom of the pot. I am going to add a little bit of water to this to help that stuff come off the bottom. I'm going to take my cup.
You're getting a cup of
water. A little tap water.
I'm just going to scrape the bottom of that pot and bring it to a little kind of fried ball there, I guess you'd call it. If you can see good, the water's turning brown, making a gravy. You can let that simmer a while, and then when he's ready, just dump it into this pot. And we'll come back to you as soon as he's done.
See how that stuff's just coming off of there? Once the water gets real hot, it starts coming right off the bottom. That's all flavor. In the culinary world, they call that font, but coonasses call it nana.
You see how everything done brown? His onions have turned a little clearer.
Gravy's nice and dark. So at this point, I'm going to take that, and I'm going to dump that into the gumbo. Watch closely.
Be careful, don't burn your ass, man. And he's probably going to stir his pot.
Now, there's a lot of grease in here. We'll separate, then I'll skim the top of it. But a gumbo, see how thin that is? Like a gum, it's like a soup, but it's a gumbo. It's not thick.
Yeah, if it's thick, then it's a stew. Gumbo's supposed to be eating like a soup, warm your insides when it's in the cold weather.
Oh, see?
Yeah, nice and brown. It's going to cook down. It could get better as it goes.
Right. So now I'm going to cook it real slow, and then whenever that grease separates, I'll skim it off the top.
Time to manger.
Almost. I'm trying to say let the good times roll, huh?
Yeah. Let the good times roll and drink beer when you're cooking. That's always a good time.
Laissez les bon temps rouler.
I'm trying to let it cook simmer for about an hour. You can let it simmer for about an hour. Then you probably going to skim his pot, get the grease off the top. And then it's up to you.
You notice I haven't put any seasoning in that. Let me tell you why. You want to season that at the end because I made my stock, has some salt in it. That sausage already got pepper and seasoning in it already. So you don't want to add a bunch of seasoning until the end.
And the chicken, when I'm done, it's chunks, but it'll almost, see how it's whole like that?
It'll almost fall apart, not completely, but it'll be tender like the rest of it. Like the gizzards and stuff will be real tender when I'm done.
All right.
Yep. Okay, guys, now y'all see the top of it, okay? It's this is the type of ball you want. We call that a blip blip. So this is just simmering right now. You see all that black stuff right there? That's all grease that will be skimmed off of there later. But we added about 30 minutes now into the simmer, and so we're just going to continue to let that cook. And then we'll check it.
Okay, he's been cooking for about 40 minutes. He turned it down to quit balling. Now he's going to let it sit. That way he can skim the grease is going to come back to the top of the pot and get rid of all that grease.
Now we're going to let it sit for about 30 minutes to an hour.
Okay, there you go. I think. Okay, he's fixing to skim the grease off the top of the pot.
That's all right. See that? That's all grease that came to the top of the gumbo.
It needs a little while to do it, but it makes your gumbo taste so much better when you do it. Beautiful gumbo, huh? Can you see the colors?
Oh, it smells really good, too.
So that's what you're doing right now?
So when we get done with this, I'll show you what the top of it looks like. You won't have as much grease on there. You'll see all the juice instead of grease.
All right,
Guys, that is the amount of grease I got off of the top of the gumbo. That comes from the chicken, the sausage, and the roux. All separates from that roux, and from the chicken, and it all comes to the top, and you skim that off. Now you can see the gumbo, right? So, that's the chicken sausage over gumbo. The wife has made the potato salad. And we'll be eating after we get through drinking. We drink first and then we eat.
I'll drink to that.
Spice Islands travels to...
All right. I got my guinea pig over here. Spice. My son, this is my youngest. We're finna serve him. We got the potato salad. And the gumbo. We got Ken that's fixing to eat the gumbo.
Grab and go. Take over the world with 100 calories. Snack. Yoplait Greek 100. There are hundreds of them to
serve from it. You see that? Right there. That's the way you do it. Right there. He's taught well. And he's fitting to take a bite. The moment of truth.
Sasebo.
That's it. Yep, that's some good stuff right there. Sasebo means good. Some people put their potato salad inside the gumbo, and some people don't. But that is a chicken sausage okra gumbo from South Louisiana. A Cajun gumbo. The real thing. The real deal.